Andy Johnson, Minnesota State University. We are looking at a diagnostic reading assessment. We're going to focus on how to do the miscue analysis of this part. Now, students have already read the reading passages, the graded reading passages. Now we are going to look and analyze the type of miscues. Now, a miscue is when what the student says doesn't match what's on the page. We don't call them errors because sometimes the miscue represents mature reading behavior, and that will come into focus in just a minute. But there are different types of miscues. First of all, there's a self-correction. This is when students make a miscue but then corrects. I do not deduct points for this, and there are many different ways of analyzing and scoring miscues, but that represents mature reading behavior. That is metacognition. The student realizes, oh, that doesn't make sense, and goes and back and corrects it. I like to see self-corrections. A meaningful miscue is when it doesn't match, but it still makes sense within the context of the sentence. The dogs run down the road versus the dog ran down the road. I deduct half a point there. Sometimes I don't deduct any, but half a point is what I recommend because students are still using what's in their head to create meaning with what's on the page. Again, that's a mature reading behavior. And then a significant miscue is when what they say doesn't make sense at all. The dogs rat down the road versus the dogs ran down the road. That is a miscue any way that you say it. And again, self-correcting demonstrates mature reading behavior. Metacognition, does this make sense? And the same with a meaningful miscue. They're still using what's in their head to create meaning with what's on the page. Now, here are the steps. As we said before, you want to audio record the graded reading passages and a separate audio recording for each graded reading passage that you do. When you are done, you're going to go back and analyze them carefully and write down exactly what the student says above the miscued words. And you can see that here. I'm writing down exactly what they say. When students self-correct, SC circle. When the miscue is a meaningful miscue, I write an M and I circle that. And again, there's a variety of different ways to do this. I recommend a very simple way like this. And again, you see me identifying the miscues and the meaningful miscues and the self-corrections. And again, I like to keep this as simple as possible. When I'm all done, I use the DRA analysis sheets. First of all, I record the target word and exactly what the student says. This gives me a good sense. We'll see a pattern. That's the first step. I also record, was it a meaningful miscue? Yes or no? Did it make sense in the context of the sentence? And you can see that here. And I like to see these meaningful miscues more than the other ones. It's a good thing. All right? Now, at the end, I score that. If it was a significant miscue, I deduct 1 point. If it was a meaningful miscue, only a half a point. If a student skips an entire line, I count that as one word and one miscue. I don't count the individual words. And I do not count proper names as miscues when that is a miscue. Under the analysis section, I record the total number of self-corrections. And again, I like to see this SC. That represents mature reading behavior. If I choose to use the comprehension section, I can record the percentage and the level. And we'll talk more about comprehension in another one, in another video. I then determine the reading rate or average. I have the passage recorded. So I time the entire time. So I go back and I time it the second time. I record the time in seconds. I divide the time in seconds by 60 to give me a time in minutes, and then I divide the total number of words to get the total time in minutes, total number of words by the time in minutes to get words per minute. Example, Pat read 119 words in 90 seconds. 90 divided by 60 is 1.5 minutes. 19 divided by 1.5 equals 79, so Pat reads 79 words per minute. That's words per minute. And you can see me record fluency right there. Finally, I figured out percentage of words. Total miscued, not miscued, total words, and then I find my percentage. That gives me a word identification score, of which I can use then to determine if that's at the independent, instructional, or frustration level. Keep it simple. Then I go back and I look at the first two columns, looking for patterns or types of miscues. If there's a certain type of letter pattern or word that gives the student problems, or if it's beginning, middle, and end. All right, that's part one of miscue analysis. I'll be looking at a qualitative analysis in just a minute.